Hello and welcome to your degree audit report or DAR presentation at California State East Bay. So, what is a degree audit report? It's an academic advising report that gives an overall view of how your courses are applied to your degree requirements, whether that be your general education and graduation requirements or your major requirements. These are based on the catalog year and effect at the time of your admissions to East Bay. If you decide to change your major down the road, then your major catalog will change. How to access or log in. Navigate to the My CSU East Bay page, follow the link below, and enter your net ID and password. Once you've logged in, select the Student tab. Click on the Student Center link, and then click in the Academic text box, and from the drop-down menu, select Degree Audit Report. What's on the DAR? Well, the first thing you'll come across is the career, which tells whether you're an undergraduate or graduate student, and the term in which you started at the university. The next line will be the program. This is actually the line that tells what your catalog year is for your general education requirements or graduation requirements. Most likely, it's the term in which you start at the university. The next line is the plan. This shows your major and the term you started. So if you start sociology in fall 2020, but decide to change to human development the next term, the catalog term would change to spring 2021. Requirements can change year to year, so it will be updated each time you change. Next is the subplan. This is either a concentration, if there is one for your major, or it can be if you declared a minor. At the bottom of the top box will show your graduation status. It will show whether you are eligible to apply for graduation, and then once you have, what your status is in the evaluation process. Next is the transfer credit eval status. This line will only show up for your transfer student and lets you know whether or not your transfer credit review has been completed. If it hasn't, there could still be courses not posted or ones not pulling into the right areas. In the box to the right will show the last term that you've registered for. So if you signed up for classes tomorrow, it would say fall 2020. And if you're a returning student, it might say spring 2017 if that was the last term you took a class. Under the academic standing, it tells you whether or not you're in good standing or on probation. Next is the overall GPA. This combines any transfer credit courses with those taken at CSU East Bay to give an overall GPA. You must maintain an overall 2.0 GPA to remain in good standing and able to graduate. Lastly is the CSU EB GPA. This only shows the GPA of coursework taken here at East Bay and must also maintain a 2.0 GPA. Okay, let's talk about the next part of the DAR, the graduation requirements. In order to graduate, you'll need to complete at least 120 semester units. However, for those of you that are transfer students, only 70 of them can come from your community or junior colleges. All of your transferable courses will be used to complete your GE, graduation, or major requirements and towards your GPA, but any units over 70 will not be counted in the total units towards graduation. Next, to receive a degree from CSU East Bay, you'll need to complete at least 30 units in residence, meaning through our university. As I mentioned before, you will also need to maintain an overall 2.0 GPA and a CSU East Bay 2.0 GPA. Next, let's review the university degree requirements. There are three areas that will need to be completed. The first area is American Institutions, which consists of U.S. History, U.S. 1, the U.S. Constitution, U.S. 2, and California Government, U.S. 3. There are some courses that can count for more than one of these areas, but to complete the requirement, you will need to take at least two courses. The second area is Writing 2 or Second Language Composition. For this requirement, you will need to take a second composition course. One of the other GE areas is A2, which is the first composition course you will need to take. The third area are the overlays, which consists of social justice, diversity, and sustainability. These can be combined with other GE or major courses, or can be taken separately. The next area that we'll cover are the general education requirements. Let's first talk about the lower division requirements. Area A consists of oral communication, A1, Written Communication Composition A2, and Critical Thinking A3. All three of these courses will need to be completed with a C- or better. Area B consists of Physical Science, B1, Life Science, B2, a Lab, B3, which can be combined with a B2 or B1, and Math Course, B4. The Math Course must be passed with a C- or above. Area C consists of Arts, C1, and Humanities, C2. An additional C1 or C2 to complete the three courses for the lower division portion of the area. All of Area C will need to include the three discipline role, which means that between the three lower division and the one upper division course, there need to be courses from at least three different areas of study. For example, a course from music, theater, philosophy, English, etc. Area D consists of three lower division social science courses and also need to have the three discipline role, and again can include the upper division course. Area E is a course in lifelong understanding and self-development. Now let's talk about the upper division requirements. There are three upper division courses that are an extension of one of the areas. The science area, B6, the arts and humanities, C4, and then a social science, D4. These courses should be taken once you have completed at least 60 or more semester units, and you must have passed the golden four, A1, A2, A3, and B4, with a C- or above. Next, let's go over the major portion of the DAR. Most majors will have the requirements listed on the DAR itself. These requirements will be based on the catalog year that you declared that major. If you've transferred in any courses and you believe that they should be pulling into the major requirements, but they're not, you should reach out to your major department, or if you have any questions about any of the requirements listed in this area. Your major department is the one that has jurisdiction over any changes or substitutions. At the bottom of the page, you'll find the last section of the DAR called Unused Courses. These are courses that are not being used to complete a GE or major requirement. However, they are still being used for units towards graduation and your GPA. Just because they're listed here doesn't mean they're not being used. It just means that they're not pulling into either the GE requirement or the major requirement section of the DAR. Now let's discuss some frequently asked questions. What do the symbols mean? Well, the green circle with a check means that the course or that requirement has been met. A yellow diamond means that the course or requirement is in progress. You've enrolled in the course currently, or you've already registered for a future term, or you're waiting on a grade to post. The red square means that the requirement has not yet been met. A purple triangle means that there's an exception that's been made. And a green arrow means that the course used was a transfer course or other transfer credit. The next frequently asked question comes from our transfer students. Has my DAR been evaluated? We touched on this briefly earlier, that if you look at the top of the DAR, there is a line called Transfer Credit Evaluation Status on a transfer student's DAR. If it says reviewed, applied to GE, then we have completed a review of your previous academic work. You'll receive an email to your Horizon email account once this is done. If it says not yet reviewed, then some of your coursework may be missing or not accurately reflected on your DAR. Please note that International Admissions Office reviews admission applications and completes the transfer credit evaluations for students who have transcripts from outside the United States. You can email the email address below for more information or if you have any questions. The next question we get is, my transfer work isn't pulling into the correct GE areas. If you have questions on how your coursework is pulling into the general education portion of your DAR, please contact the Degree Audit email account once your evaluation has been completed. Remember, check the top of your DAR to see if whether or not it's been reviewed. The next question we get is, my transfer work isn't pulling into the correct major areas. If you need help with the major portion of your DAR, you'll need to meet with a major advisor about the transferring of any courses or a plan on what to take next. The major departments have jurisdiction over this area to make changes or substitutions. The next frequently asked question we get is, which courses are transferable? Students with transfer credits from a regionally accredited four-year college or university typically find that most courses are transferable. If you have coursework from another CSU campus, we do honor the GE course list from that campus, but not their overlays. If you have coursework from a California community college or junior college, there is a great resource at assist.org. This site allows you to look up a course to see which GE or American Code area or areas it may cover, or you can look up a GE area and then see which courses are available to complete that requirement. When you log into assist.org, you can first select an institution. This is where you would put in your college or junior college. Then select the catalog year the course was taken. Make sure that you pick the catalog year that the class was taken because requirements or approvals can change from year to year. Then you would select the CSU GE Breath if you want to look up the GE approvals. This is where you could look up by department or by GE area. Next, you would select US History, Constitutions, and American Ideals if you want to look up the American Code. Here you can search by department or by American Code area, like US 1, 2, or 3. Another resource to use is TESS, the Transfer Equivalency System. If you use the link from the website provided and you enter the institution that you attended, it will show a list of approved equivalencies between CSU East Bay and then other CSU campuses, community or junior colleges, and then private or out-of-state universities or colleges. It will sometimes show which GE area that's been approved, and it may also list any course-to-course articulations that exist. Like if your Psych 125 Intro to Psych from University of Wyoming is equivalent to Psych 100 General Psych at CSU East Bay. The next question we get is, how may I obtain credit by examination as an undergraduate student? Cal State East Bay follows the CSU Chancellor's Office guidelines. Our lists of acceptable tests and general education credit are based on the catalog year the test was taken and can be found in that year's catalog. The following exams may be accepted for credit: Advanced Placement or AP, International Baccalaureate or IB, or the College Level Examination Program or CLEP. The Office of Admissions will process exams submitted prior to being admitted. However, if scores are sent to us concurrent with your enrollment at CSU East Bay, please contact the Degree Audit email account and we can post your scores. The last question we'll go over is, if I completed GE requirements at my community college or junior college, will I be done with it at CSU East Bay? Not necessarily. You might have your lower division completed, but there are three upper division GE classes in science, humanities, and social science. Like we discussed earlier, the B6, C4, and D4. But if you took them at a community college, they would not ever grant upper division GE clearance. Graduation requirements, like the American Institutions, Overlays, and Second Comp, you might have them at the community college, but they're not typical. So I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and I thank you for listening, and have a great day.